What's going on, YouTube? It's James Ong here, aka Captain Ace Rico, and today I want to talk about the Wormhole universe in EVE Online. Now, just a bit of background for those of you who aren't familiar with wormholes in EVE. The Wormhole Galaxy is a completely separate universe within EVE Online's in-game world known as New Eden that is only accessible through temporary connections that only last up to a couple of days at the most. Some of the most valuable resources for manufacturing and research are found within the Wormhole Galaxy, and some of the most lucrative star systems discovered in the game are once again located within the Wormhole universe. Now, all of this ties into a theory which I stumbled upon some years back and has fascinated me ever since. Even the way in which I discovered this theory and its subsequent removal from the interwebs is a fascinating story within itself. I stumbled upon this theory in a Reddit post by EVE Online player Valtyr Farshield, a former courtmate of mine, which laid out some interesting facts and statistics about wormholes. I'll link the post in the description of this video. But what really got my juices flowing was the now deleted top voted comment on this thread by an unknown user. See, this is already interesting in itself, and I promise you, I haven't even got to the good stuff yet. So, in his or her post, unknown user examined how many, if not all, wormhole systems, excluding the Thera wormhole system, which is kind of an outlier here and not really relevant for reasons that I won't bother explaining, but indeed, all regular wormhole systems have a near identical system found in known space in New Eden. And furthermore, when mapped out, the wormhole universe looks ridiculously similar to the New Eden universe. You might now be starting to see where I'm going with this. As I mentioned earlier, the components required to create some of the most advanced technologies in EVE literally requires resources that can only be gathered from the wormhole universe. All Tech 3 ships, things like the Sveipel, Hecate, Loki and Tengu, all require wormhole universe materials. So now we get to the crux of unknown user's theory. The Wormhole Galaxy, which looks shockingly similar to New Eden, and which has star systems that are directly mirrored in the known universe, is approximately 12,000 light years adrift from known space. Now, based on average stellar drift, the New Eden universe, which again I'll repeat, looks shockingly similar to the known universe and which has systems that are mirrored directly in the known universe, the New Eden universe will reach the approximate current position of the wormhole universe in about a billion years' time. So what if the wormhole universe is not in fact an entirely separate universe, but is actually the New Eden galaxy a billion years into our future? And when you splash through a wormhole, you are not actually visiting an entirely separate galaxy, but you are in fact traveling through time a billion years into our future. In recent years, the emergence of the Drifter faction from the murky depths of wormhole space, and more recently, the appearance of the Triglavian Collective, also ties in quite nicely with this theory. Here we have two factions, both in contact with one another, who possess technologies well advanced beyond the current levels of development in New Eden. Whilst we haven't yet made contact with a flesh and blood Triglavian, we do have some information on Drifter physiology, and it's immediately clear that this is a humanoid species. Interestingly, the Drifter race possesses and makes use of cloning technology in a very similar style to Capsuleers of New Eden. Whilst the Drifters are without question a formidable force, with papers such as the Arithmos Daily documenting the constant toll Drifters take on Eve's player base, Capsuleers have, however, had some successes against them, and when destroyed, a Drifter's consciousness will be transferred into a new clone of itself in just the same way Capsuleer cloning technology works. In the Drifters, are we perhaps getting a glimpse at our future selves, a billion years removed and with the evolutions and advancements that come with such an expanse of time? We also know that Drifters and Triglavians are in conflict, confirming that they have access to similar territories and that their galaxies do at some point intersect. In these conflicts, from what little information we have at this stage, we can see that things have not gone well for the Drifters. The Triglavians once again appear to possess a level of technology not only beyond our own, but beyond even that of Drifter tech, adding further weight to the theory that wormhole connections could in fact be access points to a futuristic and more advanced timeline. So, in conclusion, not only is a Capsuleer an immortal, swashbuckling space pilot, maybe he or she is even a time-travelling, galaxy-hopping demigod. I'd love to get your opinions in the comments section below. EVE Online players, what do you think of Unknown User's theory? Is a Capsuleer not only the personification of the great and mighty Han Solo, but also a bona fide Marty McFly? I think I know where I stand on this. But thank you very much for watching this video, and remember, as always, fly dangerous.